Hi there. It's October the 7th, and we're continuing our progress through Paul's letter to the Colossians, and we're in chapter 3, and we're reading from verses 1 to 17. So Paul has been encouraging the Colossians not to be drawn into human traditions and religious superstitions, but actually to stand in the freedom that Christ has set them free with, and that he has already made available to them through the cross and through the fact that he is now living as the fullness of God in human form. So Paul says, because of this, don't live in a dimension that is just tied to earth. He says, you are living in God's dimension. Jesus is in the presence of God as a human being, and therefore he is now bringing heaven into the earthly dimension. So it says, live with your minds fixed on things above. Live as though you were living now. Live now as you would in heaven, because your lives are actually hidden with Christ in God. Your lives are wrapped up with Christ, who is in the presence of God. And so he also says, when the King is revealed, when Jesus comes, your life will be revealed in its fullness, in the resurrection, in the life of the world to come. And this is the great hope. And therefore, he says, stop living now like you used to. Stop living now as being earthbound beings, tied up in all of the harmful things, the adultery and the fornication and the lying and the cheating and all of the things that used to go on. They're things that are earthbound. Now you are heavenbound. Now you are in a place of God's dimension. It's not just talking about going to heaven when we die, going into a place of or being separate from the earth, but actually about heaven invading earth. And so he's telling them not just to put things away, but also to put on the new things, to live the life of heaven now on earth. And so to live in the place of love and kindness and humility and meekness and long-suffering, patience. In fact, he says something interesting. He says, put the old things to death, kill them off, treat them with no mercy. The word he uses in Greek is an interesting word, nekrosate. Nekros means dead in Greek. Nekrosate means make them dead, kill them off, because these don't have any place in the new heavenly reality in which you are now living. Not just that you will be living, but because of Jesus hid with Christ in God, you are living in it now. And therefore also let that come into your behavior towards one another. Because now, Paul says, there's no division according to class and status and race, because in Christ you are part of this new heavenly reality, part of this new God dimension that you live in. So now there's no Greek or Jew, there's no barbarian, Scythian, you are no slave or free, you are one in Christ, and therefore we are to treat one another as brothers and sisters in Christ. What a powerful message Paul brings here to the Colossians of their new status in this God dimension, not just for when they die and go to be with God in the clouds, but actually now, living on earth, bringing heaven into earth, we're to put these things on like clothes, we're to wear them like new clothes, putting off the rags of the old things, wearing the new things of God's dimension. Have a very good October 7th.